Time now to look back on the week that was. Sophie McNeill, the host of Triple J's Hack program, joins us now to tell us what's been on her radar.
Hi, Danny.
Sophie. Now, one of the biggest stories this week was the PM's announcement that she's shipping out to Rooty Hill in Western Sydney for a bit.
Yeah, I think it's one of the most talked about sleepovers ever. As of Sunday, the Prime Minister is going to be basing herself right next to the Rooty Hill RSL at the Novotel right there. I'm sure she will have a nice suite there.
I'm sure.
She's going to be meeting lots of local people, holding a cabinet meeting there. And basically, it started a bit of a campaign on Twitter this week. People were making fun of this of this suburb of Western Sydney, Rooty Hill. It's a good, hard-working suburb. The honest people who lived there, they were the butt of many jokes. People say things like, oh, the PM's going to live in Rooty Hill for a week. What next? Buy a greyhound and race it. Which is a bit mean this week for the people of Rooty Hill.
Why is Rooty Hill so special? We know why it's special, but why is it important for her?
Well, basically, if Labor wants to win this election, they have to win the hearts and minds of the people of Western Sydney, and Rooty Hill is smack bang in the middle of that. There's five marginal seats there, and yeah, Gillard has to be popular there if she's going to win. The other thing, I think the ALP might be a little bit worried. There's a candidate out there who's running this election. Her name is Isabel White. She's only 22. She's a university student. She works part-time at Gloria Jean's. She's on the local council, but she's been impressing a lot of young people, a lot of people out there in Western Sydney, and she's going up against Ed Husic, a Labor MP who holds the seat by 12%, which is really a lot. So it would be take a big swing for Isabel to win that seat, but clearly the ALP must be worried. Why else is the PM spending a week out there?
Another reason for the ALP to worry, campaign headquarters fell for a bit of a corker on Twitter this week.
They did. They've got a new campaign out. It's called Join the Fight. It's their slogan, and they've got people in this campaign holding signs of the things that they say that the ALP has achieved, that this government has achieved. Climate change, doing something on climate change. They said investment in health, these are things that they want to hold up. But a Melbourne comedian took issue with this campaign, and she has made her own version, a spoof version of the campaign. Angry about things the government has done, she says, or, you know, children in detention or massive new coal developments. And Courtney Hocking got her spoof campaign. Actually, she got a bit of movement on Twitter on this, and the ALP accidentally retweeted Courtney's spoof of their campaign. And they soon realised what they did. They tried to delete the evidence, delete that tweet, but some fast-thinking Twitter users took screenshots of it before they could delete all evidence. So yes, it's still there online somewhere for people to laugh at.
Once it's on the internet, it's always on the internet, isn't it? Tassie police were also the source of a few laughs.
Yeah, they were left red-faced because they have a new campaign out too. It's a slogan, real mates don't let mates drink drive. Great idea, painted on the side of all the police vans, except no one thought about what happens when you open the door of the police vans and it comes out and it says, real mates drink drive. So all these police vans, you open them up, it looks like an ad for drink driving, of what they wanted to do. So they're going to have to remove this off all their vans by the end of the week. Apparently they've been ordered to do that.
Maybe the message will get out there anyway through that. What else has been catching your eye?
Oh, well, it was the Oscars this week, and Argo won for Best Picture. This is the Iranian hostage drama. So the Iranian government was watching very closely because they don't like this film. They don't like the way they were portrayed in it. But they also didn't like the way this award was presented, because Michelle Obama presented it live from the White House in a beautiful dress, a beautiful silver dress that the Islamic Republic of Iran, the government there, the regime, they didn't like. And so they photoshopped Michelle Obama's, I'm sure it was an incredibly expensive dress. They photoshopped it and did their own modest version for Iranian state television viewers to see.
Wonder how the designer felt about
that. Yeah, wasn't the first time the Iranians have done this either. They've done it with Catherine Ashton, a European diplomat who came to their country. They weren't very happy with her neckline either, and so they photoshopped her as well.
We'll be fine tonight. We are modestly dressed,
very
young ladies.
Modest.
No one will change our outfits later on.
Yep.
Thanks very much
no
for joining
worries,
us.
No worries, Danny.